Hey everybody, hope you're doing okay. Just wanted to give a shout out to all my subscribers. I didn't think that my channel would get this many people, and I do videos and make videos because of you guys, and I just wanted to give a second to shout all you out. Thank you very much. And let's get on with this video. So this video is going to be about the TunerView app and how to connect it to Honda Tuning Suite HTS and what all is needed. So you're definitely going to need some type of a Bluetooth module, and excuse my ECU jungle down here, but I'm still doing tuning, so, you know, that's why it's the mess. But you see, I got a CN2 datalogging, cheap little eBay Bluetooth module. I think it was like 10 bucks. So what you're going to do is you're going to download TunerView, and when you open it up, it's going to ask you to purchase. So the app itself is free, but you have to purchase the modules depending on how you're tuning. So if you're going to do Honda Tuning Suite, then you're just going to go right here to Datalog Protocol for ECTune ISR HTS. Now, if you have a daemon board or using Chrome, and you scroll through, and there's several different options. But if you're just strictly using a chip and Honda Tuning Suite HTS and like a Ostrich 2, then you're going to want to purchase that one right there. ECTune ISR HTS Honda TunerView for Android. You see, I purchased it. So we're going to click on, well, it doesn't let me click it because I already purchased it, but we're going to back out. And here we are at the screen. So I'm going to turn my key to the ACC on. And you can see the Bluetooth module there is flashing now. And we're going to come over here and just tap anywhere on the screen. And we're going to go to connect. And you see HC06 is mine. And we are connected. And if you see, I'll step on the gas pedal. See the TPS. I don't know why it says 101 now. I know that there's needs to be some scaling adjusting for the map sensor and all that. And like I said, this is my first time really using it. I'm just going through it. So, you know, you can select over here. You can go into camera mode, set all your colors, switch your layouts. Tons of different layouts here. I haven't decided which one I like the most, so I'm just going to stick with the stock one for now. But this is a good alternative if you don't have all these little fancy gauges like I do. Oh, and there's the old brick iPod. Nothing says a 1990s Honda than having an iPod set up in your car. That's all I listen to when I'm driving this car. It's got to be 90s music for this car. But if you don't have all these gauges like I do and you're tuning, this is an excellent alternative to seeing what's going on. So let's start it up and see if we can get something going. Oh. There we go. I changed my cam gear, so that's kind of why I started up crazy. But if you see the map sensor showing about -8.5 on my actual gauge, though I'm somewhere in the 18 to 20s. So I'm sure there's like a scalar effect or something that you got to do. But as you can see, it's very responsive. Intake air temps is definitely what I'm watching because I'm doing a lot of tuning. But yeah, I mean it's very good. You can hold the buttons here to set up different lights that come on, you know, your VTEC solenoid. So we'll find that. Where's the VTEC solenoid? VTS. So VTS is one, mil, check engine light is one, VTS is one. Let's see, let's do the fuel pump. Nope, that's the wrong one. So it's red because the fuel pump's engaged. And then, okay, I'll do the brake switch. And as you can see, I'm pushing the brake and it lights up. So a lot of good features on here to tell you what's going on. You know, just a lot of good things. I mean, you got tons of stuff in here. See, I'll leave it like that for now. But once I get used to playing with it, I'll come back in and make another video for everybody. So thanks for watching. Thanks for the support. Please subscribe and stay safe out there.